Hello friends, welcome to Conceptholic, the right place to get your concepts clear. In this video, we will be learning about the analysis of pre-stressed concrete beams using stress concept. So, let's get started. To start with, assume a pre-stressed concrete beam like this. The beam is simply supported at both the ends. This is the neutral axis of the beam. The beam has tendons carrying a pre-stressing force P at an eccentricity of E from the neutral axis. Let the span of the beam be L and let it carry a live load of intensity WL. Now, let us assume that the cross-section of the beam is rectangular. The cross-section area of the beam is A. Now, when I say that we have to analyze this beam, what do I mean? By analysis, I mean that we have to find out the stresses at the extreme fibers of the beam. That is, we have to find the sigma top and sigma bottom. Now, what are the stresses acting on this system? Here comes a question. So, in pre-stressed concrete beams, there are two types of stresses acting. The first one is the direct stress and the second one is the bending stress. Now, the direct stress is due to this pre-stressing force P, and bending stress are due to three reasons. The first one is the pre-stressing moment P into E. As we can see here, this pre-stressing force P produces a hogging moment P into E about this neutral axis. Here also, it will be P into E about this neutral axis, hogging moment. So, bending stress due to this pre-stressing moment P into E. Second one is the bending stress due to the dead load moment, which we write as Mg. And the third one is the bending stress due to the live load moment, which we write as MQ. Now, the direct stress, which we know that is equal to force upon area. So, it is P upon this cross-sectional area A. Now, for bending stress, we have to remember the equation which we had learnt in SOM, which was the flexure equation, which says that M by I is equal to sigma upon Y, where M is the bending moment at the section, I is the moment of inertia of the section, sigma is the bending stress at the section, which is at a distance of Y from this neutral axis. So from here we can write that sigma is equal to MY by I is equal to M upon I by Y is equal to M by Z. So we conclude that sigma is equal to M by Z. This is the equation which we cannot afford to forget in pre-stressed concrete. It is used many times in pre-stressed concrete. So, for bending stress, sigma is equal to M by Z. Now, so the bending stress due to the pre-stressing force will be PE by Z, due to dead load will be MG by Z, and due to live load will be MQ by Z. So, one more time, stress in pre-stressed concrete beams are due to two reasons. First one is the direct stress, second one is the bending stress. The value of direct stress is force upon area P by A, and bending stress are due to three factors. That is, first the pre-stressing moment, second one is the dead load moment, third one is the live load moment, and the bending stress is given by sigma is equal to M by Z. Now, with this knowledge, let us try to plot the stress diagram for this beam. Let me draw the cross section here. This is nothing but the cross section. This is the neutral axis. So, the first stress which we come across is the direct stress. Now, to begin with, first of all, we should know that in pre-stressed concrete, we take compression as positive and tension as negative. As we can see here, this pre-stressing force P is compressive in nature, so that the direct stress is also compressive in nature throughout the cross-section. So, this we take as compressive in nature. This is the direct stress, positive. Its value is P by A. This is the direct stress. stress. The second one is the bending stress due to the pre-stressing moment. We draw here. Now, we have learnt in earlier lectures that due to pre-stressing moment, the beam gets deflected in this manner, generating tension at the top and compression at the bottom. So, tension is negative. So, at the top, it would be negative, and at the bottom, it would be positive. This is negative, positive. The value of this, as derived earlier, would be PE by Z top. This is PE by Z bottom due to pre-stressing moment. Now, the third one is due to the dead load. Now, due to dead load, the beam deflects in this manner, generating compression at the upward fibers and tension at the downward fibers. So, compression we have taken as positive. So, this diagram would be like this, positive, negative. This will be the dead load moment Mg upon Zt, and this would be also Mg upon Zb. This is due to the dead load. Now, last but not the least is due to the live load. The live load also produces similar kind of bending. So, positive here and negative here, positive, negative. This would be Mq by Z bottom, and this would be Mq by Z top. This is due to live load. Now, we have written all the stress acting on the system. Now, let us draw the resultant of all these stresses. Now, for resultant, we can roughly draw the resultant. As we can see here, at the top, there are three positive terms and one negative term. So, at the top, the resultant would be like this. And at the bottom, there are two positive and two negative. So, basically, we can say that they nullify each other and it will be approximately equal to zero, but not zero. This is a rough diagram which we are making. This would be positive. This diagram varies from question to question and depends on the numerical. And this value would be no doubt P by A plus PE by ZB minus MG by ZB minus MQ by ZB. This value will be no doubt P by A minus PE by ZT plus MG by ZT and plus MQ by ZT. This is the resultant. Hope the concept is clear. Now, in question, they may give us that this pre-stressing force P is not acting at an eccentricity E, that is, it is along the neutral axis. In that case, we won't be getting this term. The second term won't be there. Also, in sometimes in question, they may say that the dead weight of the beam can be negated. So, this term won't come in that case. So, depending upon the cases, these diagrams are plotted. I have shown you the generalized diagram. Hope the concept is clear. Now, let us take a numerical so that you can understand the concepts more clearly. Now, as you can see on the screen, the numerical says that a pre-stressed concrete beam 400 mm by 600 mm in section has a span of 6 meter and is subjected to a UDL of 16 kN per meter, including its self weight. The pre-stressing tendons are located at 200 mm from the soffit of the beam and provide an effective pre-stressing force of 960 kN. Determine the extreme fiber stresses in concrete at the midspan section. So we have to find out the extreme fiber stresses at the midspan section. Now, in these type of problems, first of all, we draw the diagram so that everything is clear. Now, by looking at the question, we can draw the diagram. They are saying that there is a pre-stressed concrete beam like this, and it is carrying a live load of 16 kN per meter, which includes its dead weight also. There are pre-stressing tendons which are located at a distance of 200 mm from the soffit of the beam. Soffit means from the bottom of the beam. They are at 200 mm from the bottom of the beam. They are also given the cross section as a rectangular cross section, and this dimension is 400 mm, and this dimension here is 600 mm. Now we know that the neutral axis of the rectangular cross section lies at the center, so this distance is 300 mm, which implies that this distance is 100 mm. So we can say that in this case eccentricity is 100 mm. Always remember, the eccentricity is measured always from the neutral axis. Remember that. This is very important. Now, let us now write all the given terms in the question. As per the question, the pre-stressing force P is equal to 960 kN. Then area of cross-section is 400 cross 600, and it is equal to 24 into 10 raised to 4 mm square. Now, in this case, the section modulus at the top as well as at the bottom remains the same because it is a symmetrical section. So, Z is equal to I by Y is equal to BD cube by 12 upon D by 2 is equal to BD square by 6. And substituting the values, we get it is 400 by 600 square by 6, and it is 24 into 10 raised to 6 mm cube. Now, in the question, we were asked to find out the extreme fiber stresses at the midspan. So, we know that for a simply supported beam, the midspan moment is no doubt WL square by 8. So, this would be 16 into the span is 6 meter, it was given in the question, 6 square by 8. So, it turns out to be 72 kilo Newton meter. Now, we have written all the given data. Now, let us find out the stresses. So, as we have already seen, the first one is the direct stress acting on the system. And this is always compressive in nature, so positive, P by A. The value of P is 960 into 10 raised to 3 Newton upon area is 24 into 10 raised to 4. And this value turns out to be plus 4 Newton per mm square. The second one is the bending stresses. Bending stress we have seen earlier. In this also, the first one is due to this pre-stressing force, due to pre-stress, we can say. So here, sigma top, we have seen that due to pre-stress, it bends like this. So tension in the upper fibers, so sigma top is negative, minus PE by Z, which is equal to 960 into 10 raised to 3 into 100 upon Z is equal to 24 into 10 raised to 6, this is a minus, is equal to minus 4 Newton per mm square. Similarly, sigma bottom would be the same value but with opposite sign, plus 4 Newton per mm square. Now, the second one is due to the load, and here sigma top, we have seen that due to load it bends like this, so at top it would be compression, so positive M by Z, which is equal to 72 into 10 raised to 6 upon 24 into 10 raised to 6, and this value is equal to plus 3 Newton per mm square. Similarly, sigma bottom would be of same magnitude but opposite direction, minus 3 Newton per mm square. So we have found out all the stresses which are acting on the system. Now our main task and the final task is to draw the stress distribution diagram of the same. Now let us draw the stress distribution diagram for this beam. So I'll draw it here. This is the cross section of the beam. Here are the tendons. The first stress is the direct stress, as we have seen. This direct stress is always positive, and this value is 4 Newton per mm square. This is the direct stress. The second one is due to the pre-stress, and due to pre-stress at the top it is minus 4, at the bottom it is plus 4, minus plus, this is 4 Newton per mm square, this is positive 4 Newton per mm square. The third one is due to the load, and due to the load it is at the top it is positive, so positive, negative, this value is 3 Newton per mm square, and this value is also 3 Newton per mm square but with a negative sign. Now let us plot the resultant for this. So in the top fiber the resultant would be 4 minus 4 0 plus 3, so it would be 3 Newton per mm square. At the bottom it would be 4 plus 4 8 minus 3, which is 5, so it would be like this. This value is 5 Newton per mm square, and it is compressive throughout the cross section, so it is positive. This is the resultant. I hope this concept is clear and this question is also clear. If you have any doubt, you can always ask in the comment section. And in the next video, we will be discussing a numerical which would have an I section in it. In this case, it is a rectangular section. And in the next problem, it will be an I section. We will analyze an I section. So please subscribe to our channel for more such videos. And if you understood the concept, please like the video and share it as much as possible. Thank you and happy learning.